Oh, hi everyone. Did you know that this month, 10 years ago, Microsoft Azure was released in 21 countries around the world? That's right, in February 2010, Azure was announced generally available. Pretty cool, right? But you're not here for really old news. You're here for up-to-date service announcements and releases for news that happened in Azure this week. In this episode, we'll have a chat about a range of updates to Azure SQL for virtual machines, a public preview of test functionality for action groups, and the general availability of private access for Azure Database for PostgreSQL Hyperscale. The product team responsible for Azure SQL for virtual machines have hit the ground running this year, because there are not only one, but three updates. That's right, we now have access to deployment enhancements, enhanced storage configuration, and automated backup enhancements. All of these improvements really help to streamline the way in which you can deploy and manage your Azure SQL virtual machines. Now, Azure SQL VMs are really useful in organizations where you want to use Azure SQL Database platform as a service, but you can't. Maybe you depend on some SQL functionality that Azure SQL Database just doesn't support. And so you need to use Azure SQL for VMs. Now, it sounds like SQL for VMs is really just SQL Server installed on infrastructure as a service VMs, right? But with improvements like these, it's actually a lot more streamlined than you might think. With the release of improvements to the deployment and storage configuration experiences, you can now manage even more of the SQL configuration itself through the Azure portal. Settings like tempdb data and log files, the collation, and much more. Added to this, improvements to the automated backup see an increased backup retention period from 30 days to 90 days, and the ability to specify storage containers on a per VM basis. Overall, what we're really seeing here is a lot of the benefits you'd expect from a PaaS service, but for an IaaS service that supports more of the traditional SQL features that you might require. Did you know, just like Azure, ACG has a free tier? Yep, that's right. With ACG's free plan, you can get access to free courses, quizzes, learning paths, and original series content. For the entire month of February, the full course, Introduction to Microsoft Cloud Adoption Framework for Azure, is free, as well as a bunch of other content. And you don't even need a credit card to sign up. Now, if you're interested, check out the links in the description below. Are you monitoring your environment in Azure? I'm sure you are. And maybe you're even using Azure Monitor to do so. Now, Azure Monitor is a great tool for looking out for things going wrong in your environment. VMs with CPUs that are spiking, high memory consumption in your web apps, and much, much more. While taking that to the next step, Action Groups lets you go and do something about it. Because whilst it's good to know if something is going wrong in your environment, it's even better if we can take some automated action group. With action groups, that might be as simple as sending an email to your administrators, or something as complicated as fully automated responses using Azure Functions. But how do you test all of this functionality? Should you go and crash your production web apps or spike the CPU on your production VMs? Well, no, you probably don't want to do that. The safest way to test action groups so far has been to create fake workloads and trigger an action group there. But now you don't have to crash your production environment or fake it, because Microsoft are working on test functionality for action groups in Azure Monitor. This public preview of the test functionality allows you to simply click a test button during the creation of your action group. You can choose an alert template to use and select the notifications or actions that you'd like to trigger. The preview is currently embedded within the creation wizard, but it does provide you with a status and test details to help you build and troubleshoot your action groups. If you're using Azure Database for PostgreSQL to get all of your cloudy PaaS goodness for your open source relational databases, and you process so much data that you require Hyperscale hosting, and you need connectivity to your data to be isolated and private, well then, I've got just the update for you. With the general availability of private access support for Azure Database, for PostgreSQL, Hyperscale, you can now use PrivateLink. In this scenario, PrivateLink would help to provide secure connectivity by keeping your data inside Azure networks and removing exposure to the public internet. So now you'll be able to access your Hyperscale PostgreSQL database more securely. You'll be able to use private IP addresses for your nodes, and you can even use this connectivity from sites connected using ExpressRoute. This is a great example of where a range of tools and technologies can be used together to support your own unique requirements. Well, that's a wrap for today, everybody. I hope you've enjoyed this episode of Databases This Week. Of Azure This Week. Well, close enough, so much database news. Keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus.